And welcome back for some more Torment Tides of Numenera. I'm the RPG Chick.
All right.
Headed back to Little Nailiash. I keep forgetting the name of this maw. We're looking for Anchorage. Lost Anchorage. We found this old helmet. These guys are looking for a way back. They're right here. And yeah. What's his name? Garkoto. Just wants to know what's on the other side. So that'll take care of three all quests right. All in one. Pretty sweet. New area. As we know, the bloom makes portals to different planets, different places, different times. So, allow us. We'll go to check it out.
I'm ready.
Where no outcast has gone before. Well, maybe. Cool. So, quest updated. Codex entry. Anything else? On the far side of the moor, I found myself inside a highly advanced artificial structure. Some kind of terminal or port. The technology was far beyond the capacity of anything in the Ninth World. I should report my findings to Garkoto. We were reading about this before even looking at it. I'm aware of that, but it's too bad these don't have little exclamation marks next to them. Places, right? Lost Anchorage. In the distant past, the Anchorage was a lavish port for trade and tourism between worlds. Constructed in grand style, sparing no expense, it orbits a world that is far from your own. Civilization has built the Anchorage. The civilization that has built the Anchorage is long gone, and the place is inhabited only by Lascars, descended from those who once crewed the ships that came and went from the Anchorage. Now they are trapped in the Anchorage, maintaining its systems as best they can, awaiting a ship that will take them home. Reminds me of Mass Effect. Was it built by another civilization? And adopted, as it were, by the different races of the Milky Way. He's the very soul of action. Quest updated. Captain Janner. This careworn woman is dressed in strange, ornate armor. Her bearing is military stiff, and her eyes roam constantly. Though the rest of her body is under strict control, she assesses you in a glance. I saw that guy walking over there. Outworlder, the bloom portal is open. It is good that you spoke to me first. Few Lascars speak your tongue. Officers mainly. She clucks her tongue. We need practice. Welcome to the Anchorage. She thinks it is good that the portal is open again. Perhaps we can recover our missing people. Yes, perhaps. I am Captain Janner. This Anchorage is my command. All you see is under my command. Explore our home if you like, but our traditions, respect them, please. Tell me more about the Anchorage. The void is great and vast. It holds terrors. For the night is dark, it holds many terrors. The Anchorage is respite, a place of rest and safety. There were once many ships with many people. They came here, rested, refueled, took on passengers. Passengers traveled to many worlds around many stars, and then they stopped coming. But we remain. A place of rest and safety. There were once many ships with many people, and they came here to rest and refuel. Yes, yeah, same. Tell me more about your people. We lived here, on the Anchorage, as did our ancestors for countless generations. Trapped here, they grew old, intermarried, raised families. Our laws came one by one as we built a new society here in isolation. We are a military, Lascars, soldier sailors. We have hierarchy and strength. All know their place. All have a chance to ascend on merit. No favoritism. My own child is not even a Jemadar. I do not review her records. I could lose my position for such an infraction. She shrugs. All families have such struggles. She thinks perhaps we will serve together one day. What a wonder that would be. Such a family are we, Lascars. We struggle against time, against memory, as we keep an eye to the sky, always dreaming of escape. Until then, we hold tradition of the civilization of home. I lead. As captain, the Anchorage is my command. Marriages, I approve. I lead the rites. To me falls all responsibility for survival. She smiles. But such duties are onerous. I delegate, as captains did before me. So we have pilots, majors, Jemadars, and others. They prove themselves to work, rise to ranks. Every 10 years, those of high rank may challenge me for my position. We speak to the cortex and match our minds. We solve scheduling, mathematical, logistical problems. Should my challenger win, I retire and advise. We cannot survive without cooperation. We are Lascars, soldier sailors. We live by the traditions of our people, always dreaming of the day we return home. Are your ancestors the ones who built this place? She shakes her head. I do not think so. We lived here many, many years, but if we built the Anchorage, no memories remain. They tell us only that we serve. Perhaps it was built by our people. Perhaps it was always here. We do not know. She thinks even the cortex does not tell us. There are older things than that which we hold dear. What is that cortex you mentioned?
I'll remember that.
It is a device sacred to us, she says carefully, her eyes on yours. It is our only connection to our lost home. She folds her arms and adds, we do not allow outworlders to see it. I mean no offense, but do not ask. Outworlders are not allowed to see it. I was told not to ask, so I'm going to hold off on this at least for now. What's that pinging noise? She looks at you strangely for a moment, as if she had no idea of what you spoke, and then comprehension comes. Ah, the signal. For so long have I heard it. I have forgotten. We call for the ship. Perhaps it has become lost. If so, we light a beacon in the void. Tell me about the ship. Until the ship appears from the void and comes to take us home, we serve the Anchorage as did generations uncounted before us. Some fear the ship may never come, but we hold our eyes to the heavens in faith. She spreads her hands wide. Until that day, we toil. When the ship comes, and it comes soon, it will find a welcome berth in our Anchorage and in our hearts. It is a messenger, promised of old. Our cortex tells of it, says that it was dispatched to return us to glory. It fell into the void, and we await its return. When it comes, the Anchorage will be ready. I will have the honor of leading my people home. If not me, my successor. But I feel it will be me. How long have you waited for the ship? As long as necessary, Outworlder. She stops, retranslating your words. Apologies, we have waited for many she's thinking we mean how long will you wait. We have waited for many families, many parents. My family, their family, and their family, and back many families before them. The cortex would know, surely. But I do not think we wait much longer. Something in the Anchorage's air. It smells of our time here coming to an end. The ship will come soon. She thinks Genji's feels the same, and he would know better than any. Can I help you leave the anchorage? She smiles slightly. We are not searching for any port that will take refugees. We await the ship that will come for us. Our tradition tells us that home has not forgotten us, and that we will one day breathe its air again. Until we can reach home, we will not. She chuckles. Could you summon the ship to us or create a pathway to our native land? We would depart gladly, but not until then. I met some of your crew in the bloom. Jemadar Areki and her crew? She presses a hand to her chest and bows her head. Our thanks, Outworlder. From myself and from the crew. Should you see her again, please tell her that the way to the anchorage is open to her. And she thinks, blessed day, our people have returned to us. Okay, I want to look at the helm again. I don't want to give it over just yet. Let's see if we have any more visions. Why can't I visit the cortex? She exhales, teeth clenched, and looks up. Oops. Fury wavers like a trapped flame behind her eyes. We were not always so protective. That was before other outworlders tried to steal it a few years ago. She holds up a hand. Perhaps you were different. This does not matter. No outworlder will ever be allowed to see the cortex again. Can you tell me about anything about the outworlders who tried to steal the cortex? She growls, sweeping a hand over her head. Clearly, she regrets approaching the topic at all. You are foolish. They came to us through a portal from your world. We welcomed them as guests and showed them the anchorage, the cortex. Her hand is a fist at her side. One of them put hands on it. His friends attacked us. The anchorage, burning the walls with their fire.
Making a note.
We got a new quest. Shaking her head, she continues, We killed them, of course, all except the one who touched the cortex. We questioned him until he died, screaming a word over and over. She watches your face. The word was Dracogen. That's what he wants us to steal. Oh my. He would give us only one word, Dracogen. We will speak again, I am sure. If I'm willing to engage in some illicit business, I should see if Dracogen still desires the cortex. He might be willing to offer something valuable in return. The navigational cortex. Prized possession of the Lascars and Lost Anchorage. Why? Areki. I found a maw in Little Nylash that leads to the Lascar's anchorage. I should return to the vast interior and tell Areki the good news. Yes, I should. First, I'll look around a little bit.
Of course.
But of course. What's that? That's closed behind us? Or
of course.
It was loud. I thought we were being attacked or something. This three-dimensional image displays an evolving root-like system, or perhaps an organically growing data structure. This display shows countless suns viewed from a moving point of reference. It plots distances and routes between them at a dizzying speed. I don't speak that language. Chavon Tul Cushion Nigval.
Yes, now.
They all say the same thing. Not so many visitors come from Bloom. Welcome. So yeah, I've seen this image in the promotional materials. Like everything else in the chamber, this device is perfectly polished and clean. Every so often, it emits a loud signal that vibrates the whole room. Was that the pinging sound that we heard? Framed by luxurious curtains, this window reveals the surface of an ocean world far below. The view is reminiscent of what you saw when you were born, but the water has a purplish hue, and the scattered landmasses are brown and dead. This is clearly not the Ninth World. Dorothy, I don't think we're in Kansas anymore. Yes, Yggvar.
Why not?
We can talk to this one. This Lascar examines the contents of an open hatch in the console before him, brow contorted. Occasionally, he takes a tiny component from the tidy pile beside him and plugs it into the machine's unseen innards, waits a hopeful moment, and mutters what is most likely a curse. He spots you and gives you the rueful grin of unsuccessful repairmen everywhere. Hello. Is good to... good to... He chews his lip, thinking, good to come. He watches your expression carefully, then sighs and touches his forehead, then his lips, and he shakes his head. Speak slow, please. I hear. I try. What are you doing? He squints at his mouth, at your mouth, then nods. I fix. Try fix. Not fix. Try fix, he points at the console. What are all these controls for? He plants one hand on a set of controls. Is give information on stars. He drops his hand on the other set. Is listen to stars. For voices. For home. He stands straighter. When ship comes, ship speaks. He waves a hand in a motion you recognize as, this isn't really what I mean, but I can't remember the words gesture. I hear first. Tell all. Me. He smacks his chest with an open hand, grinning. He pauses, his hands slipping from his chest, and indicates a small section of the controls he didn't touch before. It's for Cortex maintenance, he says dismissively. Apparently his job doesn't cover that area of the Anchorage. What does Cortex maintenance involve?
I'll remember that.
His smile widens. You get a feeling that people don't usually take that much of an interest in this man's work. Genji's does most. Me? Wait for light here, he points, and then press button here. He chuckles at himself. Is difficult work. Need concentrate. He makes a furious show of concentrating on the light and then pressing the button with a finger. He chuckles again, then shrugs. Without button, no remove cortex. So, is important button. For me, I wait here. He points at his feet. Genji's does work. When work is done, lights show here. He points. And push button. He mimes pushing the button next to the dark screen. Interesting. We found out some stuff here. Something was updated, but I don't know what it was. Yeah, I guess this is all old stuff. Let me look at this. Oh, this is the helm, isn't it? Alright, let's turn his helmet.
Absolutely.
Tiber agrees. I'm not going through there. I'm just talking to her. I found this broken helm in the bloom. Her gaze flicks down to the helm in your hands and back up. She draws in a long, controlled breath. Achille, I knew she was lost to us, but I take no pleasure in it. Thank you, Outworlder. Her family will be glad to have it back once you surrender it to me. She lifts her eyebrows expectantly. I listened to one of her memories. She thought she'd found something important. Disgust flashes across her stony face and is just as quickly suppressed. I do not wish to hear of her private memories. Her thoughts are hers and should die with her. The last sentence has a lilt to it, as if Janner is quoting verse. The hard line of her mouth softens then. Achille was intelligent, adventurous, but prone to wild theories. Do not worry about her important discovery. Let it fade with her. You said you're planning on giving the helm to Achille's family? Yes, but not immediately. First, I will erase the private memories inside it, as is tradition. Then I will clean it, perform maintenance rituals. After, the helm will be given to her eldest sibling. I don't know if there's anything else to discover, so let's give her the broken helm. She takes it from you with a stoic nod and reaches inside. You hear a whispering hiss and a series of clicks. Kinda wishy-washy, huh? But... Give me the helm back. This discovery was important to her, and I don't want it erased.
Making a note.
Just give it back to us. She gives you a hard look. No, you cannot scavenge through her memories, because the helm is not tuned to you. And besides, it is forbidden. She falters, her mouth hanging open. I had this conversation once before. I had it with Achille. The corner of her mouth twitches, but she does not speak for a long, long moment. Fine, she says, sweeping a hand over her eyes. It would make her happy to know that her helm is carried by someone with her curiosity. Take it with her blessings. Oh. Achille's memory said she needed to compare her data to the Navigational Cortex's archives. Janner claps her hands over her ears, hesitates, then drops them, eyeing you balefully. She was trying to stop herself from hearing what I was saying. Do not share the memories of fallen Lascars with others. I guess so. It is not done. Understand? She stares to your left, weighing her response, and continues, Let her secrets die inside you. As I say before, outworlders are not allowed near the Cortex. Well, what a pity, Tiber says loudly. He plants a consoling hand on your shoulder and adds in a whisper, Let's just keep looking around, shall we? Perhaps we'll find a way to bend the rules, or at least, which locks we need to break. Farewell, Captain. Tiber is awesome. Okay, so there's a... something that way.
I'm going.
Either this opens automatically, like the other, or it doesn't open. It opens.
Look out below! Above! Sideways!
Pilot Major Genjis. Oh, we've heard a lot about you, Genjis. Worry stamps its lines on the features of this man. Like the others in the Anchorage, he wears a suit of ornate armor, but he has set aside his helmet. His hair is thinning, and wrinkles web around his eyes and across his forehead. He is tinkering with some display, but he turns away from it to address you. Greetings. I am Genjis, pilot major of this Anchorage. Tell me about your people. He wipes a cloth across a glare... I don't know what's wrong with me, guys. He wipes a cloth across a clear glass eye and glances at you. You have spoken with some, yes? We have lived here long. Many captains passed. We discovered we would have to wait for the ship to come. Until that time, until the arrival, we survive. We wait and we train. We are Lascars. We serve the Anchorage. We await the ship and we survive. Tell me about the Anchorage. It is many things to us, he says, his brow wrinkling. A home, a reminder of who we once were, and a promise. No, a prophecy. No. He trails off, clicking his tongue, then brightens. Can show you the Anchorage instead of just telling you about it. Can give you a tour, yes? What a remarkable idea, Tiber says in your ear. He'd have to leave the Cortex door to do it. Say yes. That's the Cortex door, okay. I'm gonna wait on that. Tell me about the ship. It was promised of old. It will carry us home, he smiles. Is perhaps ridiculous? For outworlders to understand. So many crews have passed on, so many lives ago, yet still we believe. Some question whether it comes. Many have died before its arrival, yet still we believe. What is life without belief? Why do we keep on with routines and rituals, if not for belief that someday we will go home? He thinks, the ship will come. It must. I will be the one to see it. Huh. Everyone thinks it's going to happen in their lifetime, as opposed to the centuries before them. What do you do here? I serve, Outworlder. Am keeper of the navigational cortex, its servant. I watch the sensors. I listen to its words. Information from antenna arrays filters in here. All knowledge of the Anchorage passes the cortex. If I fail in my duties, the ship might arrive without my foreknowledge. So I clean and listen and study. If the ship should come in my life, and I believe it may, I will take its mind in mine, we will plot a course for home. He thinks that day will come. I know it. I will be remembered as a hero. I am the keeper of the cortex. I clean the sensors, maintain the antenna arrays, and I study so that I will be ready when the ship comes. What is the cortex? What is the cortex? He opens his mouth and shuts it quickly. I almost speak too fast. It is our watcher of the void. It is the keeper of our history. It knows the night skies of a million worlds. It holds our traditions and tells us how to live in accordance with old crews. It keeps us alive, maintains the Anchorage. He bows his head in reverence. It alone is the voice of truth. Never has it been wrong. I feel terrible taking this from these guys. Without it, we would forget ourselves, he thinks, becoming even more lost than we already are. It does all of that? Tiber says. Sounds incredibly... what's the word I'm thinking of? Ah. Valuable. Genji's blinks several times and smiles carefully. We're gonna take this from these people? It is the keeper of our past, stranger. It remembers our struggles. It watches for the void for the ship. It is our most valued asset. I found this Lascar helm in the bloom. Does that helm belong to Jemadar Achille? He snatches it from your hands and studies it carefully. Void, take it. I hope she still survived. His accent grows thicker with emotion. Please show to Janner. Find out what Achille discovered. Make life count. He thinks, another dead. And Achille, she was my... No, I must not fall into despair. I must hope. I already showed it to her, and she doesn't want her, to find out, make her life count for what she discovered. Farewell, Outworlder. These ornate doors are firmly shut. When you get close to them, a voice says something in an alien tongue. You don't understand the words, but they sound suspiciously like a rejection. Cool. Let's do it here.
Ready.
through multiple well-polished locks. Though multiple well-polished locks line the edges, you can't help noticing that this door isn't quite as thick as the others you've seen here, and a soft buzzing hum rises from within it. A complex control panel, or possibly another lock, is in the wall beside the door. The buttons are marked with symbols you don't understand, and the light behind them flickers like a candle.
I'll remember that.
Do not touch the door, please, Genji says. The Cortex Chamber is not for Outworlders. Apologies. Oh, I thought that was led to the Cortex Chamber. This door is under his watchful eye, dear, Callistius whispers. We'll have to get him away from it somehow. Huh.
Yes.
The ancient door is still locked tight. The control panel beside it flickers with a sizzling sound. I thought we'd find our way back here, Tiber murmurs, but Genji's is watching. Be careful. You're not going to do anything. They're all going to attack us if we do. So let's try the other door before we go take the little tour. There it is.
Go.